Welcome to our online chemistry class. Our topic is chemical thermodynamics. So can you recall, we define energy, and one more question is, what are the different forms of energy? So all of you know about the transformation of liquid water into water vapors. Ice can be converted into liquid water, or all are familiar with the combustion of carbon to carbon dioxide, C+O2 gives CO2. So these changes can be carried out by change in energy. So in dry cell, chemical energy is converted into electrical energy. Other hand, if you observe the electroplating of metal, electrical energy is converted into chemical energy. So in electroplating, but carried out some chemical changes, and that can be carried out by supplying the electrical energy. So and we use the source of that energy, electrical energy, and the process is electrolysis. But when we use the dry cell, then that energy is conserved in the form of chemicals. So that energy is called as chemical energy. And when we insert that cell in our battery or in our watch, then that electrical energy is utilized in the form of electrical energy, and that is it is used for the working of that instrument. So and that is the process is called as electrochemistry. Okay, so there is one topic of same name that you learn afterwards, and the few information about this that you already learn in the 11th standard under the heading of redox reaction. So what do you realize? There must be a change from one form of energy into another form of energy. So all are familiar with the potential energy, kinetic energy, this electrical energy. Okay, then do you know, at the top of the dam, water is stored in a reservoir, and it has certain potential energy due to its height from the ground level, and its kinetic energy is nearly zero because that water is stored and there is no motion. So when we start to fall that water down, then its potential energy goes on decreasing and its kinetic energy goes on increasing. And due to, what is the reason behind that? Due to downward increase in its velocity. So potential energy of falling water is converted into its kinetic energy. So this is transformation of energy from one form to another. Then what is thermodynamics? Thermo word. Thermo means heat, dynamic means changes. So this thermodynamic concept is concerned with the energy changes either in physical and or chemical, or both physical and chemical transformation. So thermodynamics gives no information about the rate of physical and chemical process. For that purpose, you must familiar with the kinetics. Okay, and it does not give any information about the mechanism of that if it is chemical reaction. So thermodynamics only concern with energy changes. Now let us consider the terms used in thermodynamics. First is system, and second one is surrounding. So let us consider a gas enclosed in a cylinder having a movable piston. So gas enclosed in a cylinder is a system. Then outside part of this cylinder is called as surrounding. So what is the definition? A part of universe under thermodynamic investigation is a system, and all the remaining part of the universe outside that system is called as surrounding. Okay, so let us consider the T place in the cup. So your cup with T is a system. An outside area of that cup of T, that is the room, is called as surrounding. Then there are types of the system. There are three types of system. One is open system, another is closed system, and third one is isolated system. So let us consider one by one. What is open system? When a system in which there is exchange of matter as well as energy with the surrounding, then that system is called as open system. So here an open cup containing hot coffee or tea placed in a room. So if you observe this, we observe that the coffee cools down by releasing the heat to the surrounding. So there is a exchange of energy in the form of heat, as well as the water vapors from that coffee simultaneously pass in the surrounding. And such a system, that is coffee with exchange of both energy and matter with the surrounding, is called as open system. Then second is the closed system. So if you place a lid over that cup of coffee, then that system becomes closed. So if you observe this, there is only exchange of heat with the surrounding, but there is no exchange of matter, so the evaporation does not take place. Water vapor does not comes out in the surrounding. That is the closed system. A system that exchanges energy, not the matter, with the surrounding, then that system is called as closed system. Now, if we place that cup containing hot coffee covered with a lid is insulated from the surrounding, then the coffee does not cool down and there is no escape of water vapors in the surrounding. So such a system which does not allow exchange of either energy or matter with the surrounding, then that is called as isolated system. So if we place same coffee in the thermos flask, then that thermos flask does not exchange heat as well as the matter. So it is also an example of isolated system. The next one is the properties of the system. So what is extensive property? A property which depends on the amount of matter present in the system, that is called as extensive property. So mass, volume, internal energy, heat capacity, number of moles is a extensive property. So all are familiar with the mass property. So if you change the quantity or amount of that matter, mass will get changed. So you can measure 100 gram of sugar, then 1 kg sugar, 10 kg sugar. So if you increase the amount of that matter, mass will get increases, means mass get changes. Or we can measure the volume, 500 ml, 10 ml, 1 liter, 10 liter. So if we change the amount of that liquid, its volume also changes. So mass, volume, these are the extensive property. Some other examples are internal energy, heat capacity, number of moles. Then another property is intensive one. So the property which is independent of the amount of matter in a system is called as intensive property. So pressure, temperature, surface tension, viscosity, melting point, boiling point, specific heat, these are some examples of intensive property. So if you observe the temperature of 10 ml water and temperature of 10 liter water is same. So if you place water in 10 liter water in a bucket and measure the temperature, and let us suppose that the temperature will be 25 degrees centigrade, then, and if we take, let us suppose, 100 ml water from that bucket in your beaker, and if measure the temperature, and if we measure the temperature and if it equals to 25 degrees centigrade, then what do you say? This property, that is temperature, does not depend on the amount of matter or quantity of matter. So it is not an extensive property, it is intensive one. Or if you check the pressure also, it is remains same. Then if you observe the density, density formula is mass upon volume, mass upon volume. So if you check the mass and volume, these are extensive property. If you change the amount of matter, the mass and volume changes, but the ratio of these two property remains constant, and that ratio is not a intensive one, extensive one, it is intensive. So density is an intensive property. Density of water is always 1 gram per liter, okay. So density remains same, but mass and volume changes. Now next one is the state function. So suppose the pressure of a gas is 1 bar, let us suppose it is P1, volume is 1 dm³, that is V1, and temperature is 300 Kelvin, that is T1, in the beginning or initial state, and this initial state of that system is defined by specifying these values of these properties, and such a properties defining the state of this that system is called as state function. It is a state function. Then let us suppose we change this pressure from initial state P1 to final state P2. Its volume changes from V1 to final state V2. Its temperature at initial state is T1, and it will change to final state T2. And then at final state, the pressure of that system, it increases to 2 bar P2 value. Then volume changes to 0.5 dm³ V2, and temperature is maintained, remains same, that is 300 Kelvin. Temperature is remains same, that is 300 Kelvin. And this is the final state of that system, which is different from your initial state. So change in state function of the system brings for a change of its state. So these properties are called as state function. So here, final state of that system in above figure describes by the pressure 2 bar, volume 0.5 dm³, and temperature 300 Kelvin. So system continues to be in such a state as long as the state functions are unchanged. However, the pressure 2 bar is attained whether by increasing from 1 bar to 2 bar or decreasing from 5 bar to 2 bar will not be matter. add the property which does not depends on the state of the system but it depends on the path, and that property is called as path function. And that property is called as path function. So how do you define a state function? The property which depends only on the state of that system and independent on the path, then that property is called as state function. So remember this definition. Then another property which depends on the path, that is called as path function. Example is work, heat. Then which are the state function? Pressure, volume, these are state function. Then only isothermal and adiabatic reversible processes follows the unique path to bring about the changes of the state of system. Remember this. Then thermodynamic equilibrium. There are three equilibrium: mechanical equilibrium, chemical equilibrium, Consider a gas fitted in movable piston in a cylinder. The gas has a temperature T1, pressure P1 and volume V1. The state function continues to be constant as long as piston does not move and there is no exchange of heat. Then we can say that there is equilibrium. Now if we move the piston in upward direction so that gas can be expand and it passes through state from which the pressure, volume and temperatures are not specified and vary continuously during that movement of piston, the gas will be then in non-equilibrium state. If we stop the movement of piston and suppose that at this stage the pressure volume of that gas R changes to a new value P2 V2, keeping temperature remains constant, the state functions are constant since the piston is motionless and the gas is in again another equilibrium state, then again the equilibrium is re-attained. So system is said to be in thermodynamic equilibrium when its state function do not vary with time. That is called as thermodynamic equilibrium. Then there are different processes and its types. What is process? A transition from one equilibrium state to another equilibrium state, that is called as process. So first is isothermal process. It is the process in which temperature of the system remains constant throughout the transformation. That is called as isothermal. Iso means constant, thermal means temperature. So delta T is equal to zero. At initial value, let us suppose temperature is T1 and its value remains constant at final state, which is also equal to T1, then delta T means change is equal to final minus initial, so T1 minus T1 is equal to 0. As your internal energy of that system is a function of temperature, as temperature remains constant, its internal energy also remains constant, so U1 value remains constant at initial state and final state, so delta U is equal to 0. So that is isothermal process. Next is isobaric process, the process in which pressure remains constant. So at initial state and final state, pressure remains constant, so delta P is equal to zero. So if we carried out a reaction in your laboratory, then container is, if it is open, then the reaction is carried out under a constant atmospheric external pressure, so delta P is equal to zero. Then isochoric, say the process during which volume of the system remains constant during the change, and that is isochoric process. So delta V remains constant. So if we carried out that change in a closed container, then volume does not change, volume remains constant, then isochoric process. Then next one is adiabatic process, the process in which there is no exchange of heat between system and surrounding, then it is adiabatic. So neither heat is absorbed nor loss. So delta Q is equal to zero. So in adiabatic process, system is completely insulated from the surrounding. For exothermic process, heat is released which raises the temperature of the system, and if the process is endothermic, temperature falls. This results in either increase or decrease in internal energy. So this is not that exothermic and endothermic processes are not adiabatic type, they are different types. Okay, now reversible process. So all are familiar with this. So consider a gas enclosed in a cylinder fitted with movable piston, and let us suppose that external pressure is PEX on the outer surface of that piston is to be set, and that is equal to the pressure of that given gas. If there is no expansion or compression of that gas occur, the system is said to be in mechanical equilibrium. This is the another type of equilibrium with the surrounding. Now if we consider that external pressure is reduced by infinitesimal, means very very small amount. Now if the P external is infinitesimal smaller than your pressure of the gas, then piston moves out slowly, allowing that gas expand. In that case, piston move in upward direction. And if external pressure is slightly decreased so that it becomes infinitesimal greater than the pressure of the gas, then pistons move in inward or downward direction with compression of that gas. Now for the system in mechanical equilibrium with its surrounding, the infinitesimal changes may cause the process to occur in reversible direction. And the process is said to be thermodynamically reversible. The process conducted in such a way that at every stage the driving force due to the pressure P is infinitesimal greater than the opposing force due to external pressure PXT, and which can be reversed by slightly change of the opposing force, then that process is called as reversible process. So remember this definition. So this process is called as reversible process. So write down this definition if it is asked in your exam. Okay, the process conducted in such a way that at every stage driving force due to the pressure of that gas is infinitesimal greater than the opposing force due to external pressure, and which can be reversed by slightly change of the opposing force, then that process is called as reversible process. Do not write the definition of reversible reaction from chemical equilibrium in 11th standard. So which are the characteristic or features of this reversible process? The driving and opposing forces differ by very very small amount. That amount is infinitesimal, means very very less. The process can be reversed by infinitesimal change in the condition, means if we increase the opposing force by very very small amount, then the driving force, the process can be reversed. Then the reversible process proceeds infinite slowly and takes place in infinite number of steps. So it takes much more time. At the end of every step of the process, the system attains mechanical equilibrium with its surrounding. So this is about the characteristic of